Alright, so in continuance, I want to keep talking about this, I guess, sort of the exchange houses, or I can't say exchange houses because of the confusion, I can't say swap houses, but maybe there was a word, item swap or something like this, houses, warehouses. They could be massive, and we can have different variables of them. You can have the ones that have, like, the things that are really, really used, that are almost thrown away, status, and then you can have the next status up, and then you can have almost brand new in the package, you know. So these items, and then all be given, you know, we can have these, like, little cards, whatever, and then there you are, 30. Let's say you bring in 30 items, and they have a valuation of, and so let's say you have a balance, you have an account balance right there, you know, $3,000 all of a sudden, and so you have a valuation there. So that actually can be money used even by a bank. A bank could look at that as your net assets that are available. You can even use that as some kind of a collateral. I believe so. I think we could use that into the banking system. So. Yeah, so we don't want to. I'm like, oh my gosh. The only problem is, okay, you would put out, you put those rent an item. If you rent an item, I don't even know if I made this clear enough. If anybody understands what it is, you know. But you have the those places would eventually go out of business because you wouldn't need them any longer. You know, where you rent something for the day for, like, you know, $10, whatever, or $50, you wouldn't need to rent that. You would just go there and exchange swap it. Yeah, I don't know. It's just like, and then I'm like, okay, and then I underbid it. I already said like $100, you know, a year to be a member of the you know, the situation. But chances are that's probably going to be need to be like 200 or 300, and I always go under, because really you're not going to be buying anything ever again. You know, you just have that first purchase, and then just that's it. You know, you bought it one time in your life. You know, so you only have to buy that little whirly gig deal once. You know, and eventually, I guess there's a use factor. So maybe there's a use factor in the years. So to be fair, appliances maybe 7 years or so. I don't know. Each appliance probably gets a 7-year factor. But yeah, so certain things like that, maybe you do have to buy again. But very little has to be repurchased. So yeah, it is kind of a woe to the situation of the economy, because if everybody does this, we're not going to have, you know, you're going to be like, well, what about my job, I don't have work anymore, you know, I'm not, that store isn't open any longer, it's not necessary. They just go to the broken houses, like they call them the broken houses in Germany and in Switzerland. They just go to one of those, you know, and everything's switched. You know, you can run away for 3 years or 10 years and come back, and then you still have household items. It's just amazing. Oh, storage swap. I was thinking a storage swap would be the name. A storage swap. Yeah. So it does upset them, but then in essence, you also don't have to keep buying those items, and so you don't need as much work. So you don't have to work as hard, because those items, what you've already purchased it once, you don't have to purchase it again and again and again. So you don't have to keep going back to the store or wherever you work or the office again at that job. So maybe you can do something else. So yeah, so it's a little dangerous actually when you start to think about it. When you really start to think about it, you know, keeping it in a tandem equal as it's happening, you know, so the house prices aren't like, well, the house should be paid for, because you should have more money to pay for your house. However, certain stores will be going out of business, you know, as time goes on. They just will go out of business. We won't need them anymore because we are recyclers, we are reusers, we are storage swappers. We just are sharing everything. This is our future. We're not buying brand new again. And so as this goes on and this goes on and this goes on, you will see stores go out of business. And so then, how are you going to pay for that house? So that then it's a big that big deal, you know. So how are you going to have the employment supply? Yeah, so we have to have the employment supply. So yeah. So it's kind of a fun economic new. It's an economic new era, but in a different light. Much different light, because we're having. You know, just, my gosh, recycled objects as our mainstay, you know, our mainstay, rather than new objects. So it's a complete disruption to the old commercialization of the past. So it's about the job balance, making sure we have enough work that keeps the house supply paid for, enough work that keeps the rent paid for, enough work that keeps, keeps it all going. Because it's all going to be about that triple deal, you know. It's because we're talking about supply and demand, you know. It's going to be a limited supply. Limited supply of new, and the demand of the new will be much less. So in a way, it's like you can take 1/3 of the population and imagine that only 1/3 of the population is buying new, and the rest of the 2/3 are storage swappers. They just, you know, that's it. They paid their $300 a year, and that's it. That purchases anything they want in a redo. Okay, so yeah, I mean, I guess as the storage swap houses themselves will have employment, so those, some stores will switch and become those, have that going on. But I don't believe it's going to be a really, really, really high-paying deal. So we're looking at a downgrade to the rich, luxurious past. Yeah. So, and this era, I imagine, is going to continue indefinitely into the future. I believe everything that we have. Eventually, I mean, I have a ceramic, whatever, if I have a ceramic cup here that's chipped, I don't want it anymore. You know, it's going to be reused. It's either going to go to a pottery kiln factory, it's going to be going somewhere. It's going to be returned into something. It's not ever going to be trashed again. So it has a value, even at its chipped factor. So we may start looking at that type of deal also. That instead of going and groveling that cup, the contents out of the ground, the ceramics of it, we may actually just be, you know, taking anything that was broken or chipped and rehashing it. And so when we start to rehash things, that's a value. So like you drag your bottles in for you get your nickel, your 10 cents or 15 cents, you have right here, you know, you'll be dragging in your old ceramic cups that have chips on them, so they can break and remake them and refound them to something else in a kiln, you know, pottery situation. So yeah, so we have all of these different redos. And so I'm looking at the recycle process as becoming an amazing advent for new business, absolutely. Right in the very beginning, I think back like 10 years ago, it was a very short haul, wasn't it? It was just like, oh yeah, some things can be recycled. But now it's turning into much more of a segregation of items. The more and more we segregate the items, the more value they become, and they become businesses. So if you just have, you know, a plastic, I only take old plastic sunglasses, and that will be a company. A company will only take old plastic sunglasses. You know what I'm saying? And turn those into something. So that's where I'm seeing the value of your trash. We have a lot of value of our trash going on. So that can balance and help with, you know, you're like, oh my gosh, we don't have the new stores so much. You know, it's not department store Macy's everywhere in want. It's going to be more like, well, we have different types of jobs now. So we reuse things and remake things from the objects. So, and that cuts down also on importing and those types of things also, but yeah, I don't know. I don't want to get into that because that gets all like, oh, no, I don't want to talk about that element of it, of shifting. No, I don't want the factory here and putting it in another country. I don't want to talk about that right now. It just kind of wrecks what I was discussing. But yeah, storage swap was the name. Sorry, I can't figure it out otherwise, but yeah, storage swap. And that would pay for the building, that would pay for each year your particular fee to keep it, to keep, you know, swapping your items. You know, I don't like this cup anymore, and it's absolutely perfect. Get another one. you know, that type of deal. And, gosh, can you imagine just plate exchanges? Sometimes I just cannot stand it. I can't stand the plates, and I just want new ones. Yeah, those types of things. I mean, just amazing, amazing bonus that you don't have to rebuy. And so, oh my gosh, what am I, a Bed Bath and Beyond meanie? A little bit, yeah. I guess I would be a Bed Bath and Beyond meanie for some items. But in other items, maybe they have the new company that makes the sunglasses or something out of those sunglasses, you know, so that balances out. So I don't know. I'm trying to see the light here, that it's not going to be an economic disaster slowdown. You know, everybody share swapping, exchange swapping their house contents for free. But and I know that. I know everybody's like, well, just keep everything perfect. And then they do those you know, house swaps, and everything in the house is there like a hotel or whatever. It's kind of like that, I imagine. Kind of like that. So people will keep things better. People will keep their items better. Because they actually will have a secondhand value that will be so amazing. An actual bank balance. A gainable, appreciable bank balance. So you can actually, you know, state, you know, I have $3,000 worth of items, blah, 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 you know. So I believe that means, you know, lightly, tenderly, you know, gently treating objects. We'll be treating things that we purchase much, much more diligently. Like, well, maybe I don't need to waste so much paint. Maybe less. You know, maybe I'll lose just a little less. I don't really need that much on the palette. So maybe certain things are just going to start to be like that type of a slowdown. You know what I mean? We'll just use less. Because we want to keep everything like, we want to keep everything practically new. Because the newer, that means it'll have the higher value. And that'll be something that is your bank appreciation. So, yeah. I know it. I hate it. It's economy. I have to stop this video.